Good morning, dear students. In the last class, we have studied about the partial fraction expansion method. So in this class, we will deal with the next method, which is called as power series expansion method. So already we know that the basic equation of Z transformer is x of z is equal to n is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n into z to the power of n. This is the basic equations. So when you substitute any values in place of n, so you will get the different approaches or different Z transformation values. So in power series expansion, the values vary from minus infinity to plus infinity. That's what I have written it here, the x of minus infinity, so z to the power of infinity to till x of infinity z to the power of minus infinity. So if you're going to write minus at this stage, it will become plus because already minus is there. So that's why x of minus infinity z to the power of minus of minus infinity will become plus infinity. So that is till x of infinity to z to the power of minus infinity. You just remember this equation from power series expansion method. Next we will look into the problem. So this is the problem. Find the inverse Z transform of x of z is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 1.5 z inverse plus 0.5 z to the power of minus 2 ROC mod Z greater than 1. So this ROC is very important. The ROC is very important. Mod Z greater than 1. You must be careful about this ROC. That is the reason of convergence. So since the ROC is outside the circle, so because it indicates the outside the circle, the greater than 1 indicates outside the unit circle of radius 1 in the Z plane, it corresponds to x of n must be right-handed sequence. If it is more than 1, so that means it's a right-sided sequence, and also the ROC lies outside the unit circles. Therefore, convert x of z into power series having only negative powers of z as below. So now you have to write an equation in such a way that it should be in the right order, from left to right order. So first you write the denominator value outside the block. This is similar to that of long division method only. First you write the denominator numbers outside the block. This is the denominator numbers 1 minus 1.5 z inverse 0.5 plus 0.5 z to the power of minus 2. Next, numerator value you write inside the block. So this is 1. So next, now you calculate. So to get 1, what should be multiplied with this 1? To get this one, what should be multiplied this with this one? So you have to multiply 1 to get 1. So 1 ones are 1. So that 1 I have written it here. To get 1, we have to multiply something to this number. So that number is nothing but 1. So that 1 ones are 1. So we'll get 1. Next, after that, you start multiplying the remaining terms with the coefficient values. So that is 1.5 into 1, you will get 1.5 z inverse. So next, 0.5 z to the power of minus 2 into 1. So 0.5 z to the power of minus 2. So next you operate this and this will get cancelled, and change the sign. So this will become plus and this will be minus. Next. So this is the result, that is 1.5 z to the power of minus 1 minus 0.5 z to the power of minus 2. Now, in order to get 1.5, so what should be multiplied with this one? Again, you have to multiply with the same coefficient value. So if you want to get 1.5 z to the power of minus 1, you just multiply 1.5 with this 1. So 1.1 into 1.5 z inverse, you will get 1.5 z to the power of minus 1. Next, you start multiplying this remaining term with this coefficient, that is 1.5 into 1.5 z inverse, you will get 2.25 z to the power of minus 2. So minus 1 and minus 1 will be minus 2, and 1.5 into 1.5 you will get 2.25. Next, that 0.5 into 1.5, that 0.5 into 1.5 you will get 0.75 z to the power of minus 3, because the power in this case it is minus 2 and here it is minus 1. With minus 2 and minus 1 will be minus 3. Next, you operate this, and this when you change the sign, this and this will get cancelled. Next, this will be plus and this will be minus. And the remaining answer is, when you operate this, you will get 1.75 z to the power of minus 2 minus 0.75 z to the power of minus 3. Next step is, so in next we need to get 1.75. So what should be multiplied with this one? So if you want to get 1.75, again you have to multiply 1.75 with this one. So again, 1 into 1.75, you will get 1.75 z to the power of minus 2. Next step is to multiply the remaining coefficients, that is 1.5 into 1.75. So if you multiply 1.5 into 1.75, you will get 2.625 z to the power of minus 1, and here it is z to the power of minus 2, you will get z to the power of minus 3. Next, 0.5 into 1.75, that is 0.875, and the power is minus 2. In this case, here it is minus 2 and here also it is minus 2, so it will be minus 4. Next, you operate this also. Change the sign, say this will be minus, this will be plus, this will be minus, and this will get cancelled. And next, you eliminate, you subtract this, you will get 1.875 z to the power of minus 3 minus 0.875 z to the power of minus 4. So next, we have to get 1.875. So to get 1.875, what should be multiplied with this one? Again, you have to multiply 1.875 only. So 1.875 z to the power of minus 3 into 1. You will get 1.875 z to the power of minus 3. Next, you multiply this 1.5 into 1.875. If you multiply, you will get 2.8125 z to the power of minus 1. And next, 0.5 z to the power of minus 2 and 1.875 into z to the power of minus 3. You will get 0.9. Z to the power of minus 5, because here it is minus 2 and here it is minus 3, so it will become minus 5. So like that, you go on operating the values till you get 5 to 6 coefficients. Now here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here it is 5 coefficients. If you want, you can continue with the 6th coefficient, 6th and 7th coefficient, and these are the important values. Next, you write the coefficient values, that is x of n is equal to 0. This is the first value, that is the first signal, that's why it is 0 when n less than 0. Next, x of 0 value is 1, x of 1 value is 1.5, x of 2 is 1.75, x of 3 is 1.875, and x of 4 is 1.9375. And next, you write the convolution values, that is 1, 1.5, 1.75, 1.875, 1.9375. So this is one method which depends upon region of convergence. One more method is there, that is the reversal method. Look at this. So in this case, this is the same problem I have taken, that is x of z is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 1.5 z to the power of minus 1 plus 0.5 z to the power of minus 2. But the ROC is mod z less than 0.5. That means it is a left-sided sequence. It is a left-sided sequence. That is the one condition. And also the ROC lies inside the unit circle. In earlier case, the ROC lies outside the unit circle and it is a right-sided sequence. If it is a right-sided sequence, the ROC lies outside the unit circle. If it is a left-sided sequence, then it lies inside the unit circles. So here also it will going to change. You just have to write, depending upon this ROC, you have to modify this equation. You just write in the reverse order, the denominator in the reverse order. Highest power should come in first. Highest power should come first when ROC is a left-sided sequence. Here it is a left-sided sequence, that's why I am writing the highest power first. The highest power is 0.5 z to the power of minus 2. Next power is 1.5 z to the power of minus 1. And next is 1. And in the numerator, 1 is there. Just write within the block. Next. So in order to get 0.5, what should be multiplied at this place? Okay. we just calculate this. We just follow the same method. In order to get 0.5, what should be multiplied with this 1? Now that should be written at this place. And next you go on multiplying this 1.5 with this the remaining values. This is about the power series expansion method. Thank you.